Southwest aficionado here, Micah, and I'm just about to do a cigar review, but before I do, this is what I'm going to do today. It's Padron 1926. It's just a little feller, but these are great cigars. Over Thanksgiving, my brother bought these down from San Francisco, and we chewed on them all night, one right after the other. But of course, I had a bunch of English tobacco before I did mine, so, you know, the flavors were just tasting like Syrian tobacco. So don't ever smoke an English blended pipe tobacco before smoking one of these. But anyway, today I'm going to do a cigar review. I'm going to do it in thirds. I'm extremely busy today, but I'm fitting this in because I told you I'd do it like last Friday. And it's already Monday. It got busy. You know, things are adding up. I got a deadline for my book now as of December 15th. It's got to be done. The last installment on the Pepito anthology I was doing. This is the 10th volume. And I made myself a deadline finally, because I'm putting it off and putting it off. So I got to finish. I've got approximately 10 days to do it. I got to have it edited and loaded up to Amazon by the 16th or 17th at the latest, probably before Christmas. Anyway, before I do this cigar, I thought I'd do a quick review on my lunch. It's my vegan sandwich. I know it looks like hell, look at it. You say that's enough mustard on there? Anyway, it's extra grainy bread, baby spinach, tomatoes, green, hatch green roasted chili, onions, and a little bit of chopped fresh garlic, a little bit of salt and pepper, a lot of pepper, some La Tapatia hot sauce, and slathered with the cheapest spicy brown mustard I can find, because you know the more expensive stuff is too smooth. You buy the cheap stuff from Walmart for 88 cents and it's got a lot more horseradish flavor coming up your nose, blowing the top of your head off, and that's what I like. So anyway, I'm going to do a quick review on the sandwich. You guys might not want to watch this. I'm not going to do it in thirds like a cigar. I'm just going to take a few bites and give you my first impression. It's going to be messy. Drop my napkin. Hold on. Mustard in my nose. Mustard on my nose. What's that? What? That's a hell of a sandwich. Oh yeah, avocado. They just fell out. I'm gonna stuff it back in. Have another bite. The chili is really hot. I got the extra hot this year. That's even better than the first bite. I love eating vegan. All the food is good for you. I load up on protein with my nuts, cashews, almonds, and a lot of whole grains, farro wheat, quinoa, and one other one that I can't remember. Loaded with protein and some beans. Is that the better than a vegan sandwich? Listen to old Hank. Old Hank. That's the new Hank. And not Hank the Third. The original Hank. Wrap them down here. I'll light up that cigar. But every time I step myself and feed my face like this, you know what it reminds me of? Reminds me of the first smoke in the band, I believe. Jackie Gleason goes into that restaurant. He orders an El Diablo cheeseburger sandwich, whatever it was. Steps it down about 3, 4, or 5 bites. And he says, Widow. That's what this reminds me of. See, this is like an El Diablo sandwich. That green chili is hot. But it is so good. I'm gonna finish this sandwich and I'm gonna clean up a little and I'll be back with that delicious cigar review. So adios amigos. Hello everybody, Southwest aficionado back. I just finished hosing myself off with all that cheap spicy brown mustard. I've already lit up my Padron 1926 series. And any of you who smoked these before know that they're great cigars. I mean, the wrappers on these things are just the most beautiful thing I've ever seen. You know, kind of like the nice, great color of the, maybe that wrapper. Oh, a big Sumatra wrapper. They're beautiful too. But these really thin, silky, smooth, silky Maduros on this one are just fantastic. But anyway, I've been smoking these for years and I like them. Actually, the whole line of Padrones. Even the lower end ones, you know, the 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, those are fantastic cigars. You can get those for $7, $6. These are a little bit more pricier, but these are their top end cigars. And then they have the one Connecticut, the Dimaso. I think I smoked that a while back. Up for Connecticut, that's an awesome cigar. That thing has flavors you wouldn't even think, you know, come from a Connecticut wrap cigar. Right off the bat, you know, it's just so leathery, full of cocoa, a little bit of coffee. You feel those baking spices starting to come in right in the background. Yeah, it's real gentle. Real bready. I mean, everything hits you at once. They don't wait. Which is nice. I'm trying not to smoke these too fast. There's a little bit of a twinge of a jalapeno on there, but I think that might be from the sandwich, you know, the green chili I ate. Probably should have waited a good hour before I ate that sandwich, but I gave her 2-3 good minutes. And I couldn't take it anymore. But like I said, I got a lot to do writing that book. Anyway, the walk was good this morning. I walked really fast because I knew I was limited on time today. And when I do that, it just takes me, you know, an hour and 10 minutes to do my walk. I'm a speedster when I'm determined. A lot of nice, gentle spices on the bottom now, right on the palate. A little nutmeg, cinnamon. And that cocoa is just right behind him. He's kind of pushing those baking spices on the palate. Really nice. And a nice and leathery feel to the smoke as you take it in. Anyway, I'm going to shut her down here for a few minutes and I'll be right back. Give you my final impressions. We just won't drag this out. I mean, everybody knows it's a great cigar. main thing was just eating that sandwich on camera. But that's over with. Anyway, I'll see you in just a few minutes. And I'm back, everybody. Still listening to old Hank. I'm so lonesome I could cry. Cigar is doing fantastic. Just so creamy and cocoa-y and leathery. There's a little bit of sweetness trying to come in. It's kind of a real subtle sweetness with a little bit of anise on the back end. Really interesting. Little bit of cremated coffee in the background. Kind of nice. Real nice. But I know everybody's taste is different. But I tend to go for more of the heavy Maduro profile with a lot of black pepper, coffee, cocoa, and stuff like that. And a little spicy on the end. Of course, this cigar is very refined. Tobaccos are just aged properly and everything. Not too much pepper in this one. A little bit on the retrohale. But you know, everybody should be able to enjoy this cigar. Doesn't matter who you are. If you're a novice just starting out, or you just like mild Connecticut cigars, you're still going to like this. There's not too much flavor, but just enough to pique your interest to the whole damn thing. We're going to shut this off because I don't want it to run too long. I already did the vegan sandwich review. And we pretty much know how this is going to end up. That's some good chooching. Well, I just wanted to mention to Ben, the Unicorn Piper. That was an excellent review you did the other day on your cigar. You do a good job. Very thorough. I like it. I tend to do that when I write my reviews for the Facebook page, the TP Smoke Shop page. I'm pretty thorough, get a lot of information on the cigar, but when I do a video, it's just to have fun and enjoy the smoke. And just try to convey a little bit of what I'm tasting. Well, anyway, you guys have a great Monday morning if you find that possible. I'm going to finish this stogie, just kind of relax, chill out. Then I put the laptop over at the table, shut that TV off for the rest of the day, and hammer out the rest of my little book here, because I want to finish it. It's the 10th story, and I've been wanting to start my novel, and I'm at that age where if I don't start it now, it may never get finished. So I think I know what I'm going to do. I'm kind of torn between maybe doing another series of short stories, because I enjoy those the most. They're easier to write. I never wrote a novel, but I'm anticipating that you have to do an outline and follow it and that kind of thing. Short story, you can always just reread what you wrote the previous session and pick right back up where you left off. It's a little easier. Things just pop into your head, you write them down, you edit the damn thing, and you're done. You know, a novel will be a little bit more intense. Not that I can't do it, but I don't know. I'll probably just go ahead and try it just to see if I like it, just to get one out of the way. Yeah, it'd take me about five months or so to write it. Depending on how long my writing sessions are. If I can really dedicate, you know, 3-4 hours a day, you know, I'll get her done pretty quick. But these short stories, you know, they're between 7,000 and 10,000 words. It's not a big deal. Not enough time to develop any of the characters. They're meant to read over a span. That's why I like doing an anthology type series of books. The same subject, same person maybe. Because then by the end of that, you know, you get an idea of what's going on in their head and how they came to be. Yeah, if you get my books, you know, sporadically, by number 9, by number 8, 4, 7, you know, you kind of get lost because it's kind of a chronological order that you have to read them to get the utmost enjoyment out of the characters and where the book, the anthology, takes them from the beginning to the end. But any of you who are interested, just get on Amazon, Google my name, or go to my Facebook, Mikey Cabrera author page, and give it a check. You can actually check them out for free on Amazon. Just download the Kindle reader on your phone or laptop or tablet, and just read away for free. It gives you a small sampling of each book. See if you like it. See if it's something you want to, you know. It's not a big investment. They're only like $2.99 a piece. But I don't do it for the money. I mostly do it for my family to read them. And some people in California that know me, they buy them. And I just have fun doing them. Anyway, the cigar is pretty much staying the same. And that is beautiful all the way through. You can't go wrong with a Padron 1926, 64, the lower line 1000, 2000 series, or their one Connecticut Damaso that they make. I recommend them highly. You'll never go wrong. Okay, guys, have a good time, and we'll catch you on the next video. Bye-bye.